with us because it's the first speech after the summer. So please pay all the attention to my next question, which was the most important moment in your life. That single moment that changed your single life. Think for a while. You have it? You have it? What do you think? I think there's no one single moment in our life that changed our life. Because every moment affects us. Every moment, every day, what we live with our family, our friends, our relatives, is constructing our life. Let me share one true story that happened some years ago in a Washington DC metro station. Probably most of you have heard about it. This is a true story, as I said. And it's about one musician that took up the violin and began to play in the metro station. And 2,000 people walked through in the next about 45 minutes listening to a wonderful piece of music. There were six most difficult Bach, Sebastian Bach pieces for violin. What happened in those moments? Many of you can imagine that we are in a hurry, so when we leave from the metro, we don't have time to listen to the wonderful music. So most of the people just hurry and didn't pay any attention. But there was the children, and there was some middle-aged woman that, yes, they throw some money into the tin. That was after 4 minutes playing. After 6 or 10 minutes, one man laid against the wall and was listening. Yes, paying attention. He slowed down the pace and stayed for a while listening. But what happened? He watched and has to attend the meeting, schedule, whatever. So, what I'm trying to tell you is that after those 50 minutes that this man was playing, only 20 people has thrown the money. He just got $35. That's not important. Important is that nobody stands and nobody recognized who was the player. The musician was the very well-known and famous Joshua Bell. He's a very well-known musician, 40 years old, 2 days before this social experiment, organized by the Washington Post, was celebrated. This person was in the theater in Boston, and it was all sold, and every people has paid about $100 for listening to him. So, you know, we reached for a final conclusion. What we have to think about it is, if we don't have time to enjoy these beautiful moments, special moments that the light is bringing to us, we have to recognize that we are, you know, filling our agenda with so many tasks, with so many activities, that many days we don't have a second just to peace down and just think about the important things that we have to dedicate our time. What are those important things? Of course, our thumbs. How many of you have family? How many times, as a father, as a mother, have you thought, I don't dedicate as, you know, the quality or the time to our sons? When was the last time you went to the theater? Or when was the last time you enjoyed an opera? We have to find that time. So my proposal after the summer break is just find your time, enjoy the moment, do it, find whatever you want to do, and just put all their, you know, the passion on that, because there are beauty around us. What happened in that experiment? When, you know, one person you don't expect in one place, that's not common to play this beautiful music with a violin that costs $3.5 million. What happens if Europe, we don't recognize talent in those moments? We have to pay attention to this anecdote just to think about it. So to finish, I I want to share with you what I have discovered during my summer holidays. I discovered, thanks to my husband, one thing called meditation. Yes. Finally, I discovered what is to find 3 or 4 minutes a day to stop, to sit, close your eyes, feel the silence. The silence is not just the absence of noise. The silence is to think about what are the real important things in your life. What are your real objectives? What are your aims? What you want to do with your life? What you want to be? What you want to provoke on your friends? So in these 3 or 4 minutes, just think about and find what are the important things that are going to construct your daily life and your future. And it's what I try to persuade you. Find time, go for it, and if you're really, really love that task or that book or that music, do it. Find the time and do it. Thank you.